It's Fernando Ruiz Art.
Hi, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. And we are looking at a sneak preview of one of my pages for the upcoming Die Kitty Die Starstruck number 2, which is the latest Die Kitty Die story by Dan Parent and myself. So this is one of the pages going in there, and as you can see, I'm in the middle of inking this one. So I'm pretty happy with my spaceship there. What do you think? There's my spaceship blasting off with some Kirby crackle there. So keep your eye out. Die Kitty Die Starstruck number 1 is available right now on Gumroad for a digital download. So number 2 will be out shortly. We're in the middle of putting that together. And then we'll have issue 3 and 4 and some other surprises. And then the hardcover will be available this fall. The hardcover collection of the entire story will be available this fall. All right, so keep your, and also always remember to visit diekittydie.com for all of your Die Kitty Die needs. Check out the store. You could get our past hardcovers. They're available there. And actually, you know what? I'll link to it because I think it's been a while since I've done that. I'll link to the Die Kitty Die website in the comments below so you guys can check it out more easily. All right. It's been a while since I've picked up on our perspective lessons, so I thought I would do that today. And I had been going through a few things with one point perspective. I still want to go back to one point and do a few more things. I want to talk about the grid and how to do a proper grid. This week in my basic drawing classes and my online basic drawing classes for the Kubert School, we've been talking about two-point. So I thought I would talk about two-point today. Okay, so I have put down a horizon line. And as I've discussed in previous videos, the placement of the horizon line is totally up to you guys. It could go wherever you want it to be. I'm placing it roughly around the center of my page just to make things easy and easy to see. Okay, so now I'm gonna put a simple cube into two-point. The first thing I wanna do, once I've got my horizon line down, is I want to draw, I'm using my rolling ruler here, I wanna draw the angle of the cube that is closest to me. So I'm gonna say, and I'm totally guesstimating as to the height of this cube. Let's say this is the top, and this is the bottom of that angle closest to me, okay? If you remember in one point when we drew a cube, we started with the plane closest to me, but in two-point, you're gonna have an angle. A corner of the cube will be what is closest to you. Okay, so now I need to place my vanishing points, and this is two-point perspective, so of course I'm gonna have two vanishing points. So I'm gonna pick, and those vanishing points, they could go anywhere you want on the horizon line, anywhere on here, so long as the two remain on either side of this angle, okay, this corner. So I'm gonna place my first vanishing point, and just to keep it, you know, fairly easy, fairly in the shot, I'm gonna go out here, okay? I'm gonna go way out here. And I'm gonna call this vanishing point left, okay? Now, my other vanishing point, I'm gonna go to the other side of this angle, and I'm gonna go out here. And I'm gonna call this vanishing point right, okay? So I have vanishing point left, vanishing point right. Can we get them both in the same shot? There we go. Okay, now, and one thing to keep in mind, and your sense for this will increase the more you do this, the further out you push these vanishing points, the less extreme of an angle you're going to get. So sometimes you may look at a box in two point and it may look really sharp at you. It may look really extreme to you. If you want to avoid that, and sometimes you do want something to be that extreme, but if you want to avoid that, push the vanishing points further out. And in fact, your vanishing points can be way off the page even. In fact, they could be way, way off the page. And that's where perspective gets to be a bear. Okay, so now, and of course, you know, I mean, you could have, if you bring them in to close to this line, that could be correct perspective, but it'll look weird. It'll look very extreme. So just be aware of what you want. And like I said, the more you do this, the more your sense for vanishing point placement will sharpen. Okay, so we've placed our vanishing points. Now what do we do with them? So I'm gonna go to that angle. Remember, I have a top and a bottom to that angle that I started with. And I'm gonna get my ruler. And I'm going to connect the top of that line that I just drew. I'm gonna connect it to vanishing point left. And the bottom of that line that I just drew, I'm gonna draw that, connecting it to vanishing point left. Now I'm gonna do the same thing again, but this time going to vanishing point right. So I'm gonna connect the top of my line, make sure I get that in there, top of my line to vanishing point right, and the bottom of my line to vanishing point right, okay? So now I have two planes, and they're both receding to infinity and beyond. So I want my box to have a very definite end to it. I don't want it to just go shooting off to my vanishing point endlessly. So I'm gonna follow any one of these lines, either the top or the bottom, it doesn't matter. And I'm gonna decide, okay, I want my box to be that deep, okay? So I'm gonna go in, making sure I'm staying perfectly parallel with the vertical of that first angle that I drew, and I'm gonna go to that point that I just put down, and I'm gonna go straight up, straight up, straight up. You could measure this, of course, to be far more accurate than I'm being with my rolling ruler here, but that's up to you, and I'm doing a little bit of freewheeling here just to keep this moving and quick for you. Okay. So now I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side. I wanna determine how deep this side of the box should be. And I'll go around here. Okay, and I wanna do the same thing, staying nice and vertical and parallel to all of my verticals, okay? So now I have my three verticals, my three vertical lines. And these new lines that I just added, they have a top and a bottom as well. Okay. Let's put the two point in two point now. So I'm gonna go to my left vertical line, to the top of my left vertical line. And I'm gonna connect that to my vanishing point right, and I'm gonna draw a line receding in that direction. Then I'm gonna go to the bottom of my left vertical line, and I'm gonna draw a receding line to vanishing point right, okay? Now I'm gonna do the same thing, but from the tops and bottoms of my right vertical line. Okay, so I'm gonna connect from the top of this line to my vanishing point left, and I'm gonna draw a receding line. I'm gonna go to the bottom, connect it to my vanishing point left, and draw a receding line. Now, if I've done this correctly, okay, I'm gonna have receding lines intersecting right about here, and I'm gonna have receding lines intersecting right about here. As I said, if I've done this correctly, and I did do a little bit of freewheeling by not doing a lot of measuring, but I should be fairly close still. If I've done this correctly, these two points should be directly, and they almost are, directly above and below each other. And I could close them up, and there is my box, and I'm just darkening up some of these lines so you could see the box. I know with perspective and all these construction lines and reseating lines, I know sometimes the box itself can be hard to see, but I want to make sure that you guys do see it, that you guys can see what we've done here. So I'm just darkening up these lines. And we will be left, hopefully you can see it. There we go. We are left with a box in two-point perspective at eye level, okay? This box is at eye level. What I want to do in an upcoming video is draw a two-point box below and above eye level, and you could see the differences in that, what that will do to your box. But that's two-point. That is very basic two-point perspective. Notice we've got one plane receding in this direction, another plane receding in that direction. We're not looking straight on at the box at all, because therein lies the road to one point. We are looking at two angles, two receding planes on this box, receding each to a separate vanishing point. So that's how it's done. I hope that made sense. I hope that was clear. If you guys have any questions at all on this, please, please, please put them in the comment section below. I'm always happy to try and answer any questions or comments that anybody has. If you enjoyed this, if you think this made sense, please click like. Feel free to share. Anyone that you think would enjoy seeing this, who needs a refresher on perspective maybe, please feel free to send this their way. I could always use new viewers. So I'm gonna continue with my perspective series, so please keep tuning in. Please subscribe and hit that bell for notifications so you'll be called back when new videos are up. And thanks again for watching. I will see you at the next video. And keep drawing, everybody. Keep drawing. Bye-bye, everybody. Thanks a lot.